Paranthropus, a fascinating branch of our ancient hominin family tree, has long intrigued scientists and enthusiasts alike. Today we will delve into the intriguing world of Paranthropus to unravel the secrets of this remarkable group of hominins. Paranthropus means beside man. This name infers that Paranthropines were not direct ancestors of modern humans. Perhaps Paranthropus was just a variation of the same kind of ape as the Australopithecine, as some paleontologists think. These heavy-set hominins with broad faces first appeared around 3 million years ago. They inhabited the southern and eastern part of the African continent. Paranthropus appear to have been the plains hominins adapted to life outside the forest. They typically inhabited open savanna grasslands where giraffes, elephants, and wildebeests roamed. But they had to eke out a tough living. They were preyed upon by the large carnivores of the time. One concern was ancient crocodiles, which launched ambush attacks from bodies of water. For example, Crocodilus anthropophagus, which means eater of humans in Latin. More dangerous were leopards. Direct evidence comes from the cranium of a Paranthropus robustus. The skull cap has two distinct puncture marks caused by the lower canines of the leopard. Besides leopards, the primary predators suggested for the Paranthropus were saber-toothed felids and hyenas. Paranthropus coexisted in Africa with some early human species. How much these different species interacted remains unknown, but their contemporaneous existence suggests our ancient relations were quite diverse. As you already know, the genus Paranthropus currently includes three species: Paranthropus ethiopicus, Paranthropus boisei, and Paranthropus robustus. All three species exhibited hyper-robust masticatory apparatus, as evidenced by their sagittal crests, extremely large jaws, and molar teeth. The old picture of Paranthropus only eating nuts and seeds has slowly fallen away. In fact, these hominins had a diet rich in grasses, herbs, and forbs. So their powerful mouths were used to eat as much grass as possible in one sitting. They also ate tiger nuts and wild nut grass tubers. But such sedge and grass diet is nutritionally poor. Therefore, the species had a small brain capacity, about the same as the modern gorilla. Estimating the height and weight of Paranthropus is challenging due to limited skeletal remains. They were likely relatively small in height and weight compared to modern-day humans. Average weight and height are estimated to be 40 kilograms at 132 centimeters. However, Paranthropus species were athletic and physically active. They had a powerful upper body and strong forearms that were used for tree climbing. The majority of scientists believe that these species did not manufacture stone tools, but they may have used sticks or bone tools to access the tubers or termite mounds. Paranthropus ultimately went extinct. However, their disappearance is a subject of ongoing research. One theory is that Paranthropus were so specialized that they couldn't cope with environmental change, while our direct ancestors thrived on a diverse menu. Thank you for watching. See you next time.